Hi, thanks for watching the Weekend Box Office Report. I'm your host, Daniel Kay. Today is the report for the weekend of January 6th through 8th. Only one new movie on the chart this week, because it's January. I told you about January last week. It's no man's land. It's the wilderness for film companies. The movie that opened, by the way, The Devil Inside, made $33 million, which is pretty good, and it's going to drop like a stone next weekend. Just bear with me on that one. Let's see. So, rounding out the rest of the list, because I feel like doing that, Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol, $19 million. Good. Sherlock Holmes Game of Shadows, $13 million. Also pretty good. The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, the American remake, of course, $11 million. Alvin and the Chipmunks, $9 million. War Horse, oh. Poor Steven Spielberg, by the way. War Horse made $8 million. For a grand total of 56. Further on down the line, at position 8, The Adventures of Tintin, also directed by Spielberg, $6,727,000. I saw Tintin this weekend. I rather enjoyed it, but, you know, that's me. Let's see. Number 7, We Bought a Zoo from Cameron Crowe, $8 million. Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy, $5 million. And The Darkest Hour, which pretty much describes this week in the box office. $3.1 million. Alright, so let's see what else is interesting here. I'm browsing just along with you. You can look behind me over my shoulder and see what I'm seeing, if that wasn't already apparent. Not so much. Roadie, 2012. There was a movie called Roadie starring Meatloaf in the late 70s. But this is the new version of Roadie, and that made $2,600 on one screen somewhere. From Magnolia Pictures, which means it probably simultaneously appeared on HDNet, but I don't have HDNet. Do you? Nobody does. Nobody has HDNet, to Dan Rather's dismay. That's it. There's no more box office to report. Thanks for watching. Tune in again next week. Tune in being, of course, an antiquated term describing how you would view this. Maybe I should do it in 3D.